Hey, welcome to the North American LCS Week 2 Day 2 Recap. I'm Dr. Monocle, and up first we have the veterans of Team Curse facing off newcomers Vulcan Command.
Flash in middle and Xsmithy Red Saint for the comeback. But he leaves the lane that time, and Saint stays aggressive here. They go back in. He gets the Glitter Lance, but not onto Jackie. But Jackie stopped to auto-attack. It happened the best way for Mandatory Cloud. It's going to be Saint probably coming back into the flash from Jackie. They look to grab first blood, and it goes to Saint Vicious. Xsmithy coming in. He could find some trouble here, but it's a low mana bar for Nijackie. Saint is saying run. Nijackie's saying keep going, Saint. And it's going to be Xsmithy on the trail here. He gets the red buff proc on. It's going to be taken away. Can he get the next one on the Q? Misses. He's got one more attack, and he finds it just over the edge.
Damage, whereas Nidalee's building full tanks. So when the teamfight does come, they're going to get it for free. Yeah,
yeah,
those pink wards are gone. Yeah, it's, Muffin Cutie's not going to be able to steal that by himself.
No, they have the
ward
there.
That's a ballsy call by me.
Here comes the power cord. They do get the pink ward, though. Cop forced to cleanse that one off. A great Cataclysm does lock in vain. There's the ultimate, but Xsmithy's going to head back into the fight. A lot of focus onto St. Vicious. Cop is able to do so much free damage, and he picks up a kill for himself there as they chase them out. Curse had a great position advantage on this one. They're going to turn it around. There's the teleport from Void Boy, and it's going to leave Psycho Sid top.
Fight.
They are
trouble.
Making some dangerous moves, but they have to right now. This is one of them. Great damage onto Cop, but he's on the outside. The Crescendo stops the bullet time almost completely. Can they turn this one around? They're just taking way too much damage. Xsmithy trying to put out the DPS, but he cannot. Elements just standing there taking all the shots for his team. It's the only thing that Xuna has to focus, and it's not going to equal a kill. It's going to be 3-1. St. Vicious went down a little bit earlier on that, but Curse finds their first definitive fight. St. trying to blow the cooldowns as he stands in front. They look to take this inhibitor as it goes down. They are able to stop it there, but Xsmithy almost gets shredded down immediately right there. St. may find his way out of this. They get Muffin Cutie to go down, and they are forced back out of the fight without even a turret to fight on them.
All right, so Vorboy had teleport up that whole time, so even if Psycho Sid was able to get something, like, Vorboy teleported in, it's just going to be the end of the game.
Like, they crushed it down. That's all they needed for the last fight, and they're able to take down the Nexus. Just off of that, Mandatory Cloud and Psycho Sid trying to hold this one in. It's going to be 30 minutes in that all Curse needed to take this one out. Really, the teleport coming in.
Our second game of the day features Team Dignitas taking on Good Game University.
Clems is going to go for a 3-on-1 dive.
Deep pressure in this bottom lane here. Fat takes a good amount of damage. He will go down for first blood. Patoy takes the aggro, walks out safely. 71 to 71 on the CS there. Here comes by Crumbs from the outside. They go for the flash engage. Immediately 100-0 coming in onto Zion Spartan. But here comes the reinitiation. Skara taking a lot. Patoy again to come in with the security guard save. But he may find himself going down here. A lot of low HP bars for Dignitas. Crumbs could fall. Patoy forced to flash. Ace in the hole takes down Crumbs. Patoy trying to save the KDA and the cows on the run. Cutie Pie from the outside trying to thwart them off with a bit of Mystic Shot damage, and they buy it. These are not initiations that they can do with mistakes. There it goes. Patoy gets a great hit, a headbutt, or flip back rather. They are able to take down Fat. They've been doing it since the beginning, and they focus them right off the bat here. Can they find more kills, though? It's always been the one for one or the one for none. It looks like that's all they get once again. No, they go in once more. Beautiful job by Crumbs and Scar.
Like I said. Yep, they got the. They're not rushing anything, even
right.
though they're so far ahead. They're very composed. They're not going to rush it. Now they're going to go in for some kills, clean these up, make me raise our KDA. Oh, they miss it.
There we go. Skara diving in. He throws down the Zonias perfectly. You can see GGU knows the engagement is not there for them, not even the re-engage. It's the poke comp that needs to come in for them here, but it may be too little too late. They're only tickling away the health bars of Dignitas. The turrets start to take damage on the Nexus. It looks like Dignitas may be coming up for another W in the win column as they go for the second turret there. It's going to be Fat being controlled on. He gets put up and down by Assault and Battery. There's just too much focus onto the champions. Now onto the Nexus. It looks like Dignitas able to take out GGU in the second game of the day.
Yep, congrats to Dignitas.
Next up, we have the 3-2 TSM taking on Team Mern.
Got about 10% by, oh my gosh, Mega taking so much damage at the bottom lane. Exhaust is on as well. Can he get out? He's got Ghost on. One more attack. Is it going to be enough? He flashes for it. Kayak's going to rocket jump back out. 400 gold for him. Behind the brush, Mega does not know he's there right now. We'll see if that happens. Clicky D is nearby, and now he's on turret. Here comes the odd one. He's got the stun. Yep. Here comes the Twisted Advance. The rocket jump on there as well. Especially if she flashes out of range, and now Mega Zero's taking all the damage. Odd one is there. Here comes Clicky D. Can he taunt him back into turret range? Not quite. And Reginald comes to show up and as well support this.
No way.
A 4-on-1 tower dive. Clicky D flashes away.
They're going to keep
aggro
going.
Is gone. They are still going in, but KX has aggro. KX will go down. He picks up the kill back onto Clicky D, but it's 3-1.
People don't want to put in the overall investment if they're not roaming the entire map. Mm-hmm. So the pink wards is really what controls the dragon fights nowadays. Everyone roaming up around here. Both top laners do have their teleports up. This could be the fight we see. Marn teleporting to engage.
All right, that's going to be Mega Zero right there. But they're going to see that Dyrus is right on top of them as well. And they're going to immediately pop up. Heartbeat. He's going to cleanse backwards, try to get behind a wall. The team has grouped up. There's well. Rage is going to get the pull, lands it onto Atomic, and Shadow goes on Atomic to keep him alive. Clicky D is going to fall, though, from that. They found Chaos. Can they get the burst? He cleanses the slow, gets over the wall. He's going to be safe, actually baits the team pretty well. Reggie picks up Mega Zero. That's a 2-for-nothing. They're going to get the root onto Atomic, and there's no turret there to keep him alive. Puts the slow down. That's going to be 3-for-nothing right here. And Reggie's in behind.
Oh,
he finds
wow.
Heartbeat. 1v1 against Echo. Doesn't quite land the Q. Puts the stun back onto him, but Echo, now the only one alive. Reggie almost finds the damage. An odd one is still chasing. Gets hasted by the dissonance. There's a sapling. It will not chase him down. Echo, the only living member from Mars.
Much just keep that held down until the next wave gets here. I wonder if TSM is bold enough to dive through this turret. So the wall does come off, and Chaos is just happy shooting it.
Wow, look at the damage up out there. 3 shots to go to the turret falls. That's going to be a turret. Omni gets caught by the stun, does not have flash. Where's the damage going to come from? Looks like they do summon to Mega Zero. There's the initiative from the odd one. Finds Echo, knocks him into the air. Shen, oh, great. Shockwave's going to find Echo.
Ooh.
Knocked into the air. That egg is going to be boiled right there. And he jumps right in. KX is just looking for a kill. Will he grab Mega? Yes, he will. Clicky D, the next one. There's the Bunny Hop's going to find another one. Exhausted to KX, and he is happily walking forward. Another kill there onto Atomic End. 13-3. TSM are looking for the Nexus.
Wow, they just rolled through them in that team fight. It was the game of attrition, and TSM finally cracked the egg at the end of it. Here comes the Nexus turrets.
There we go. TSM putting themselves at 4-2 so far. Great job, man.
Our final game of the day features two newcomers, Good Game University and Vulcan Command.
Of course, they've got a stun from Taric. Smithy moves forward. They're going to go for it right here. They're going to land the stun. Arcane Shift, EQ, cleanses. He's going to go for the flash pretty soon. Exhaust is on him still. Look at the damage output. And there's First Blood. I can hear Zuna yelling very loudly. Which they see intended once again. He's going to get the pillar down again. Here comes the damage on a Mancloud. Needly is 6. Exhaust goes on him. But here comes Xsmithy. Can they turn this one around? Mancloud getting dropped so very low. Does not have much of anywhere to go. Zion's Bar is going to jump back forward. There's the kill picked up. Gets out of range. But here comes the Requiem. Is it going to be enough damage? Zion Spartan looking for the heal. Nope. EQ for Xsmithy is going to find that one. I'm surprised he shifted out.
And Nintendude X caught out with 10 health as well as Psycho Sid. 1v1 tower dives. Bad. Wow. Fighting pro comps as you get tired of it. But now GGU actually looking to push into Vulcan. That may be their mistake.
It's taking a lot of damage to Nintendo. He has ulted there. There's the dunk back forward. He's going to be forced to flash away again.
Oh,
however,
wow.
A lot of crowd control. Are they going to find Mancloud? He's must run away. Nice heal comes out there from Muffy Cutie. They're re-engaging those Sid, taking a lot of punishment. The Iceborne Gauntlet really helping them. He actually goes back in to buy time for his team. And a minion there, and there's no bullet time to stop the minion wave. Xsmithy goes back in. They found Zion. They found Bloodwater. A lot of damage. Zion's going to jump back. Mancloud in the front. Xsmithy goes down. They found 1-for-0 so far. And V are going to back right. Oh, the javelin from Zion. Spartan picks up another. There's the Requiem. Is it going to be enough? No, Fat takes a heal. He's going to be fine. And the push is going to continue.
And they just keep the heals up with Nidalee. They're going in for Zuna. The kills keep going. That's 4.
Oh my gosh. There are 4 now dead right now. Only Muffin Cutie is alive. And GGU are onto the inhibitor. I don't think Taric, as fabulous as he is, can 1v5 this. Killer goes down to make just more slows. They've got a purple turret. Minions by themselves pushed up the top lane. That is a really good pickup. But here comes the engage. Xsmithy looks for the dunk. Here he goes. He's going to find Nintendude a bit of damage. Look at the counter damage, though. Holy cow. Nintendude is tanky. Zion Spartan, though, not liking his life very much, nor his Bloodwater. They are very, very low. However, GG manages to disengage again.
Trundle just saying, hey Jarvan, you're trapped in here with me as the fight keeps going. Oh man!
Oh man, they get one from Fat and 1, 2, 3. They are picking up everything. Fat, he jumps away. However, he's going to fall down immediately to Karthus. But that was a 4-for-1 right there, and they're ready to keep pushing.
They have the Nidalee healing. They know there's an open inhibitor in the mid, and it's just Psycho Sid to defend. They might be able to end it on this push.
Well, the inhibitor is down. They've already got 2 super minions as well, and they've got 30 seconds until the next respawn. They group up. They go for the bottom turret right now. Psycho Sid goes in onto Mashby. He's going to take some counterattack damage, but he is still a pretty tanky man. Goes down to half, and the team is still here to push. Ezreal ult goes down as well. That is one turret dead. Sengoku goes in. He's been sheeped. He's going to fall down. That is the kill picked up. The ace, 15 seconds on respawn. Good game. University are going to look to find their first game, their first win here in the LCS. The Nexus is all it's going to be, and that's going to be theirs.
And they did it with two really subs. A new Bloodwater in, Zion Spartan in mid, Fat in the top lane.
Hey, thanks for watching. Check in the description for the picks and bans and standings for today. Also, if you actually want to watch the full game, just click on one of these four videos. I recommend watching Game 4, which was Good Game University versus Vulcan Command, two new coming teams. It was pretty good. Also, like, favorite, and subscribe.
Coming up in Season 3.
It's a really big question for these guys.
Coming up in Season 3.
Who are they going to focus on?
CLG, GGU,
TSM,
CLG,
GGU,
TSM,
CLG,
GGU,
damn it.
Dignitas,
Dignitas,
Dig,
Curse,
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 Marn,
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 Complexity,
Marn,
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 Vulcan.
I want to play TSM and just destroy them.
We're just gonna play.
Play our game.
We're just gonna play.
Play the game.
We're just gonna play.
Playing the game.
You mean like the game?
Yeah.
I got hit by a spear too.
Kill him! Kill him! Kill him! Kill him!
I love you guys!
Woo! Woo!
Yeah, there we go.
Go!
I'm so good at this game. Oh my god.